I'm Chris with Tennis Warehouse. Welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. We've got a second edition, the part deux for you of the playtester picks. So let's check in first with Tiff and see what she's rocking out on the courts.
I'm going to kick it off with a playtester pick around here, a favorite ball for us. Every time we head down, we usually are playing with the Dunlop Grand Prix tennis ball. We just love these because the ball is very consistent right out of the can and is really long lasting. So these are the balls that we are hitting with most often. Next up, I have a long sleeve. This is the Fila Essential UV blocker. Sorry. It comes in three colors. I have the white here, but it also comes in black and navy. And I know in some parts of the country, it might actually be getting cooler, even though it was 100 degrees here yesterday. I like these UV long sleeves because they go from summer and into fall. This one has a UPF 50 sun protection, so I love that during the summer months. And then as we go into fall, it also keeps me a little warm on those cooler mornings. I know they're coming here soon, even though, like I said, it was 100 degrees yesterday. And lastly was a recent playtest of the T-Fight 295 RS. I picked this one because I was really surprised how much I liked it. And my own personal racket is a 305, so dropping 10 grams, I wasn't sure how much stability I would find out of this one, but I was really liking how quickly it swung and how comfortable and stable this racket was when hitting ground strokes and up at net.
All right, let's start off today with a little focus on the string. The string bed definitely matters, like the ball. Everyone's gonna start connecting me with this string. This has become quickly my favorite setup. This is a hybrid of Zyx and Kevlar. Obviously, Kevlar is not known to be the most arm-friendly fiber, but the way Ashaway is able to braid these things, it kind of brings the stiffness down. Combined with the Zyx, which kind of has a stiffness rating close to that of natural gut, this is just a chocolate and peanut butter string bed for me. Who knew these two strings would go that well together? So one of the stickier setups I've had, low-powered, I'm able to really manipulate the ball, change what it is I'm doing with this string bed. Not much of a string snob, but now that I've been playing with the string, this has become kind of the point of reference hybrid setup for me. Next up on, we got to have a pair of shorts here. I've got the kind of the USPS blue version of these Game Set Ergo 9-inch Adidas shorts. Really like them a lot. Very breathable. Just a great elastic band around it. It kind of has a shoelace here with a rubber tip at the end of it. These things last many times through the wash and dry cycle. One of my favorite pairs of shorts for sure. And then last but not least, I just want to shine a little emphasis on this New Balance Rally Print Crew. This also comes in kind of a, they call it a steel green. I preferred this because it's just a little bit more of like the harvest, Thanksgiving, fall colors. Really enjoy this. Very breathable, looking great on the court, and kind of matches well with that gray short as well.
All right, I got a few products for you as well again this week. First up, I've got a shoe that I'm really enjoying, and I'm probably in the minority when it comes to the playtesters here, and that is the Adidas Stycon. Now, I have a very narrow foot, and I think this shoe fits so snugly. It's obviously a laceless tennis shoe. You can see no laces there. And it has these support straps internally in the shoe that really are aggressively tight around the foot, and I think if you do have a wider foot. Some people are finding this shoe a bit too restrictive for them. But for me, with a narrow foot, I usually wear two pairs of socks. This one I can pair in just one pair of socks or two. And then when I'm done playing, the shoe is so just locked on and solid. It really is a really stable and supportive ride that I like to get the shoes off and let my feet relax a bit because they're very tight fitting in there. But on the court, love the shoe. I don't slide a lot, but this shoe I probably slide more than I would in any other shoe just because I feel so safe and secure in it. Ton of support and stability out of that one. I love it in this new black white colorway and has a little bit of aggressive speckle hit on the outsole. So that's a great offering right there from Addy. Next up, let's have a look at a string from Head. And I've been hitting this one a lot. I got to hit some early sets of this. And this is Lynx Tour. And it's a shaped poly, as you can see from the package there. Offers really nice ball pocket. Great access to spin. Also found it to last pretty well in my rackets too, as far as durability is concerned. Doesn't notch too early or anything like that. So really nice control-oriented poly right there from Head. Been enjoying that one out there. And then last but certainly not least this week, I've got the Yonex 98. This is the E-Zone Tour, 98 Tour. So this is a beefed up version of that 98. And for me, it just made the feel of the racket super plush and forgiving. Really love the response of the racket up towards the tip, getting some nice power up there. And that helps me get a little bit more hop on my serves and good access to pace and spin also on my groundies. And then As I mentioned on last week's vlog too, I'm injured right now, so I've been playing two-handed on both sides. This one brings a bit more mass, and it's really helping me to drive through the ball and maintain depth and pace during rally situations, and especially on return of serve. So I think this is a great racket, intermediate through advanced level players. Give this one a demo. I think you're going to love it. That's all we got for this week. Thank you so much for watching.